everything. You could have helped me, but instead you beat me to death.
My name is the Larry Wilson.
This is my time.
I was born and raised in North Minneapolis. I was raised by a single father. Pretty much my mother left when I was about 2 years old. My brother was one. So it was just pretty much us three until my dad remarried. I'm not saying that I didn't notice the absence was there, but you know, it never negatively affected me as much as an absent parent would with most children. Pretty much since I was about 12 years old, she's been in my life, my mother, since that entire time. From then, my dad's wife, my stepmother, she pretty much did a lot of the primary motherly duties. It went from it being a couple of us to us having a big family, and you know, we're all pretty close. And so I'm very blessed to have that in my life. But I started rapping when I was about 4 years old at a local talent show hosted by our local radio station, Camo J. I entered this contest, you know, and I won the talent show. And I think I made a freestyle and started rapping. And I think from that moment on, I knew I wanted to pursue hip hop. When I was about 13, I started freestyling. I wanted to be a battle rapper until, you know, I realized that a lot of battle rappers outside of competitions, they don't really sell records. And so I began to focus on songwriting. It was hard because around that time, it was about 2000, 2001-ish, where, you know, a lot of the rappers were talking about drugs and sex and violence, and I just felt like that wasn't truly who I was. I just always felt like it was something more to life. I didn't think you could be a preacher and be an MC. I thought it was impossible because I had never seen it be done. So I was going to quit because I thought a lot of gospel rap was just the corniest stuff I've ever heard in my life. The truth. That guy right there, The Truth, he's the one that made me say, you can do this. I was watching TVN one night. I don't remember the show, but he performed this song called The Portrait on there. You know, he did his little spiel about why, you know, believers can be MCs, and I agree 100%. And then he just, you know, he didn't do nothing epic. The Portrait, that was a really thought-provoking song. And it was that day when I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to rap about the Lord and just do it the best way I can. Fast forward, you know, I'm now an MC, but I'm also a preacher of the gospel. I answered my call to ministry when I was 17 years old. I knew that I was called to do something that involved the body of Christ. And when I started ministry, my biggest thing was, you know, I used to run a lot of women. A lot of that, you know, stemmed from me, you know, just being hurt and I guess make myself feel good. And you know, when I would engage with them, I would see they were catching feelings, and I never understood that. You know, it's because you have a soul tie. Why do you think when, you know, people, they lay with each other when, you know, the dude don't want to be with the girl, but he get mad when she kicking it with somebody else? It's a soul tie. That's why they get mad. You know, I took ministry serious. I was young, but I took it serious. I remember I went, it was a guy I've been knowing, had been knowing since I was about 10 years old. He got killed, and I remember being at his funeral, and like the church was packed with people my age, and I'm sitting in the pulpit. Like, it was like, it was deep, it was powerful. Around the time I reached adulthood, I kind of stopped, you know. I'm like, dang, you know, it's a lot I don't know. You know, And it was like the devil was tricking me to thinking that in order for me to be an effective preacher, I would have to live a wild life, you know, so I can have something to preach about. And, you know, that's a lie. That is the biggest lie, you know. Some people's testimony is that the Lord kept them from stuff, you know. And a lot of people don't realize that, you know. So people who find themselves in wild situations, like, I want to tell, you know, the people that's watching this, that just because it's some things that you don't need to know. When Adam and Eve ate the fruit, they didn't know evil. You know, they let the devil trick them into knowing things. There's things you don't need to know. You don't need to, when they ate that fruit, they knew pain, they knew heartbreak, they knew disease, they knew broken bones, they knew dispositions, they knew all kinds of stuff. You know, it's something that we just don't need to know as people. Because they say ignorance is bliss. But it's two types of ignorance. It's ignorance, like, you don't want to improve, you don't want to know things to build you up. And then you got ignorance as, I've never been exposed to the foolishness that life can bring. And I think that type of ignorance is bliss. You don't need to know paternity tests. I didn't need to know paternity tests. I didn't need to know trips to the clinic. I didn't need to know, you know, porn addiction. I didn't need to know drugs. I didn't need to know alcohol and, you know, hormones and whatever else. I didn't need to know all of that. But I do now. And, you know, you use what you go through to give God the glory. You know, you don't have to allow that to define you, you know. And I'm a firm believer in that. If you put God first, He'll take care of everything. Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and all His righteousness, and all other things will be added. I believe that, you know, you put God first, you put living for Him first, the things that you want will, you know, manifest itself. Because if you put Him first, the things that God wants becomes your wants, you know what I'm saying? And that's how it works. That's why a lot of people aren't prospering in life right now, because they're not putting God first. They're not giving Him glory. They're not trying to live for Him. This is mainly for those who claim to be believers, who, you know, claim to be children. You can't, a lot of the people that's listening to this may or may not be parents, but if you're a parent and your kids aren't listening to you, they're not taking heed to what you say, they're not being obedient, and they ask you for something, they ask you for this and these great big things, and you're apt to say no. You know what I'm saying? And God is the same way. If He's our Heavenly Father, you got to believe that He has a parent mentality when it comes to His children. Yes, He wants to bless you. Yes, He wants to, you know, give you things, but why would He reward disobedience? You know what I'm saying? So it's the same idea. So I would leave off telling you, you know, put God first, obey His word, and He'll take care of you. He'll bless you. He'll allow things to manifest itself for you.